What's going on, guys? It's Omniarch, continuing bringing you a brand new video where I'm going to be telling you the 6 worst legendary commanders to invest in Rise of Kingdoms. I'm going to need an F's in chat, boys, because this is the last game fuel from the fridge. Cheers. Now let's talk about Charles Martel, okay? Charles Martel, I'm just kidding, he's not on the list. I just wanted to put him up here to get people freaking out for a second. Charles is still the man, I love him, don't worry. Now originally the idea for this video was to narrow it down to 5 of the worst legendary commanders to invest in, but I whittled the list down to 6 and then I couldn't figure out who to remove. So we're calling it 6, we're gonna talk about the 6 commanders that I think are the worst investments, okay? And let me just get this out of the way up front, okay? Because anytime we talk about the best commanders or the worst commanders, or I make a guide about a commander, there's always someone, at least one person in the comments who's like, Omniarch, I actually saw one time that somebody used this in a garrison once for a KVK a year and a half ago, and it actually did really, really well. Guys, listen, this is a super complicated strategy game, okay? There's a lot that comes into play when it comes to a battle report, okay? It depends on people's equipment. It depends on, you know, are the commanders maxed or not? Some players aren't even there's not T5 in the rally. Like, there's so many things that can influence battle reports, okay? So there's gonna be some commanders on this list that I'm sure you've seen used effectively, okay? Because again, it's a strategy game. You can find a use for pretty much anybody, okay? But in terms of investments, right, if you're gonna say, hey, Omniarch, I have 1,000 legendary commander sculptures, who should I put them in, right? These 6 will never be on the list for me. I will never be like, oh yeah, you should invest in that commander, because I think personally that these are the bottom of the barrel. So before you drop your comment, yes, I know some of the, maybe you've used them and maybe you've seen them. I get it. Okay. I get it. But I'm saying in the grand scheme of things, would you tell your friend to invest in them? Absolutely not. Now we're going to be working backwards from number 6 all the way down to number 1. And number 1 is going to be, in my opinion, the worst legendary commander to invest in. So number 6 just barely makes the list, and it is none other than Moctezuma. Now this commander just barely makes the list. Okay. And I gotta be honest, we gotta see some more testing, because this is still one of the newest commanders in the game. But I just honestly, I don't see a good reason to invest in this commander over virtually any other commander in the game at the point of recording this video. And again, I could be wrong, and if so, I'll pin a comment in 3 months if we find out Moctezuma is broken for some reason. But just hear me out, okay? He's a Mightiest Governor commander, which means you're gonna have to invest a lot just to unlock him and compete with everybody else in your kingdom, okay? And now that the Mightiest Governor is pick 1 of 3, is Moctezuma really gonna be better than your other 2 choices? I really don't think so. Secondly, he's a peacekeeper and he's a leadership commander, which means he's not min-maxing on really anything here, okay? He's built for mainly fighting PvE content, barbs and sports and stuff like that. And also, it's historically known that the best commanders in the game are focusing on a specific troop type, whereas Moctezuma just isn't. I'm also not impressed with his direct damage factor. I just don't think that it's very good. And also, it's only for a single target. And also, yes, there's a 15% counterattack damage reduction, but you know, whatever. Yeah, it's 4 seconds, slightly longer than normal debuffs, but who cares? Now, the only thing that could make this commander good is if we find a way to abuse his Jaguar Warrior skill, his 3rd skill here, because you do get a really solid healing factor every time you inflict a normal attack against a target inflicted with a health reduction debuff. Now, he does apply a health reduction, but only to PvE content, right? Only to barbarians. So, you know, you would think these two, yeah, they have synergy, but not against other players. So you have to pair him with somebody else who's also going to inflict a health debuff if you want to use this healing factor in a PvP scenario. And the only commanders that I can think of that do that are Aethelflaed and Chandragupta with his stacks, I think of exhaust. So you might be saying, oh, hey, that's a good use, right? You could use him with Aethelflaed or you could use him with Chandra, but is Moctezuma really the best pair for Aethelflaed or the best pair for Chandragupta? I really don't think so, right? Maybe you could counter rally with like a Chandragupta Moctezuma, right? Maybe. But like, is that your best counter rally choice? I don't think so. And now you're healing your rally, like you're healing your rally, so you're gonna get more debt. I don't know. I just don't see the use. You know, maybe one day there'll be a commander that will really abuse this healing factor and it'll make him really good in the open field for PvP. But for right now, I just don't see a good pair for him and in a way to make this really, really good. He also only gives you 20% of stats and it's attack, right? He only gives you 20. There's epics in the game that give you more battle stats than that, which is kind of awful. And yes, I know that he deals direct damage factor when he takes skill damage, and you know, theoretically that could be good in a large group fight, but there's just so much working against him that like, are you really going to use him just for that? And it's on his 4th skill. skill, which means you have to bring him up to 4 stars and hope that all the points go there. I just don't see it, right? I don't see it. He's a rally commander. If you're a free to play or low spender, you shouldn't really be investing in rally commanders anyway. And even if you want to, there's better options, right? So I just think there's every little thing that makes me think, oh, maybe he's good for this one thing, or oh, maybe he's good in this scenario. It's just, there's so much working against him that I don't see him as a relevant or good commander in this game. So for those reasons, unfortunately, Moctezuma makes the list, coming in at number 6. So it only gets worse from here. Coming in at number 5 is our boy Lu Bu. Now, this is another relatively new commander. He came in with the Dynasty Warriors special event, and there's just not that much to like about Lu Bu, okay? First of all, you had to buy a bunch of bundles just to get him, and if you don't have him now, I don't know how you're gonna get him. Maybe he'll show up in Card King one day or something like that, or maybe he was a timed exclusive and you can never get him again, which, hey, if that's the case, then I'm fine with him being trash, because then that's not fair for all the new players. But regardless, his AoE, let's talk about his AoE. It's literally worse than Sun Tzu. Sun Tzu is an epic commander that you can literally start the game with if you pick China, and his AoE is worse, right? It's literally worse. He deals 800 damage factor, only 3 targets, right? And each target is reduced by 15% damage. If you take a look at Sun Tzu, Sun Tzu deals 800 damage factor, and it's not reduced by 15% for each target. And he also deals an extra 200 damage factor afterwards. So Sun Tzu's better. Plus, he gives you more rage. Now, okay, Lu Bu, of course, does do that defense reduction, which is fine, but there's other commanders that do a defense reduction in this game. Even if it's only 30% or something, it's not quite as high as Lu Bu. Is that really the reason to use him? Really? Is that it? On top of that, this is another rally commander who's not specifically focusing on a specific troop type, so you're not getting all the benefits of the specific troop trees that we see in this game. You have the leadership tree instead, which just isn't that great. His second skill is only useful for rallies, and not only that, it's only for city rallies. You can't even get the increased damage when you're hitting a flag. Like, what? Plus, he only gives you 15% of stats. For a legendary commander, you only get 15% of stats, and it's attack of all things. The worst stat that you could possibly want, right? And I'm not saying attack is a bad stat, but I'm saying attack is an abundant buff. You can get attack points in so many other ways. And the fact that he only gives you 15% of attack, like, come on. Now, he has a chance to pop off an 80% without Dao Chen, which is fine, but it's for 3 seconds with a cooldown. And his fourth skill is nothing to write home about either. You just bring some more troops into the battle. I don't understand. I think they must have wanted to put Lu Bu in the game as a bad commander, so that way new players don't feel bad about missing out on him. That's the only thing I can think of, because he's so terrible. He's absolutely awful, and there's no reason to invest in him. Number 4, we are going to be taking a look at our boy Frederick. Our boy Frederick, he's an OG. Some people hold him near and dear to their hearts, but guys, Frederick is not a good investment. He just isn't. I'm sorry. I know you maybe saw one time he was a good secondary in one rally or something like that. I don't know why people like to say things, but listen, Frederick is not a good investment. Okay. Let's just be real here. Let's be honest. Okay. I don't care about those little nuanced one-off things that you saw, or, oh, this is a good pick. It's not. Frederick's not a good, he's not a good investment. And here's why. Okay. There are literally no skills on him that provide stats to your troops. Like, nothing. You don't get stats. You pick Frederick, you don't have stats. Boom. That's it. That's the end of the story, right? You don't get any attack, defense, nothing. There's nothing there. Frederick doesn't provide any stats to your troops. Absolutely awful. It's trash. It's garbage. He also only has single target damage factor. Now, if he is expertise, yes, he may be dealing a really nice amount of skill damage to that one target. And, you know, you could be typing in the comments, oh, you could do a city rally with Frederick in KVK1 and he's amazing. Like, sure. Okay, listen, but let's be real. I hate the argument of saying, oh, he's good in KVK1. Because you know what? Any expertise legendary is good in KVK1. Literally, pretty much anyone, unless they're a gathering commander or something like that. If it's KVK1, there's so few players that have legendaries expertise that if you do happen to have one, that means you're a mega whale. Okay, you're a mega whale, because the kingdom's not that old in KVK1. And we're talking about long-term investments for free-to-play or low spenders. And Frederick is just not it. Again, he's another rally commander. He's a leadership conquering commander. We're seeing a trend here in this video already. His third skill, only for hitting cities, literally does not apply when you're hitting a flag or a fortress. Like, seriously, why? Even if it did, this isn't even that great. It's 10% of damage. Great, that's fine. fine, but like, come on. Plus, now you're healing your rally. Are you gonna heal your rally with 1,000 healing factor? Like, that's decent in the open field. And don't get me wrong, Frederick has a 5-5-1-1 in like your Canyon team, for example, early game isn't that bad because you're bringing more troops. But man, I don't understand, why would they make a legendary that just doesn't give you stats? I don't get it. Anyway, coming in at number three is what I like to think of as Frederick's worst brother. Yes, it does get worse than Frederick, okay? And that is Julius Caesar. Again, another leadership conquering commander. What is going on here, Lilith? Do you not like the leadership? Like, what's with the leadership tree? So let's talk about Julius Caesar, okay? Because I know that there's some Julius Caesar lovers out there, and I gotta break it to you, man. He's not a good investment. He's just not a good commander, okay? His first skill, well, let's just be real for a second, okay? No skill damage. He gets skill damage on his expertise, which means congratulations, you just wasted 700 legendary commander sculptures to get a 400 damage factor expertise. Seriously? Absolute garbage. Absolute garbage. Don't even, why? That's an insult. I'd rather it not even be there. Like, I'd rather his expertise just do nothing, because like at least then you'll know, hey, you really messed up and you should get better at the game, okay? Other than that, he provides no stats except for on his active skill, right? His active skill gives you 40% of stats, which, hey, guess what? There's other legendaries in the game that give you 40% stats all the time. All the time. Look at Zenobia, right? You get 20% defense, 20% health. Like, that's a, they're the same rarity. Are they really the same rarity? Let's come over here and take a look so we can just quickly embarrass Julius Caesar here. It's 20% health, 20% attack. Now, yes, it's for infantry only, but again, when we're talking about players min-maxing, like, that's what you should be doing. You should be focusing on a specific troop type, okay? Julius Caesar doesn't do that. He doesn't have the benefit of a talent tree that focuses on one troop type. So yes, you're getting 40% of stats, but it's only for 5 seconds, right? And, you know, other legendaries will give you that all the time. All the time. Now he does have 30% increased damage, but where's the damage, bro? What normal attack and counterattack damage? Like, okay, you could use Attila and Takeda and have really high normal attack and counterattack damage all the time. And guess what? They're also legendary commanders. So Julius Caesar, absolutely embarrassing, absolutely trash. Now he has a little teeny bit of tankiness here, but literally so does Sun Tzu. Literally so does Sun Tzu. It's 10% less damage taken on his third skill. Hello, Sun Tzu's literally a better legendary than some of the legendaries on this list. It's hilarious. Now he does take less damage under 60%, but like, if you have a Caesar rally or a Caesar army out in the open field that's under 60%, just kiss your hospital goodbye, because it is absolutely filled up. This is not going to save you because you don't have any battle stats and you don't have any skill damage. You don't have any, there's no shields. Like, it's just terrible. His third skill not only has, it's only a 10% chance of happening, but it's only for hitting cities, not even flags or forts. Like, what is going on here? Absolutely disgusting. And yes, his last skill, you can maybe use Caesar again in your Canyon early game, 5-5-1-1. You bring more troops to the field. Congratulations. Okay, maybe. But again, Caesar, just absolutely, there's so much missing here. And it's so sad because Julius Caesar is like one of the most well-known legendary actual commanders in real life that people know about, right? Et tu, Brute. Like, everyone knows this. And here we are. He's number three on this list. But guess what, guys? It gets worse, okay? Because worse than number three is number two. And he comes out around the same time, and his name is Hannibal Barca. Hannibal Barca comes in at second place for the second worst investment I think you can make in legendary commanders in this game. Now, the reason Hannibal Barca is worse than Frederick or Caesar, despite you thinking like, hey, maybe there actually is more uses for Barca than there is for Frederick and Caesar, right? You may be thinking that, which you might not be wrong, but here's the problem. You get Caesar and Frederick for free by opening gold keys. Hannibal Barca is nearly as useless as those two, except you have to have a high VIP level and you have to buy his bundles for like $300 or something insane like that, just to get a commander that's virtually as mediocre as those two that you can get for free over time. Now, he may be slightly better in some certain scenarios, or, oh, KVK1, he's a great rally commander. Like, dude, again, everything is good in KVK1, because if it's a legendary that's expertise, then that's what do you expect, right? But hey, if we're going to talk about KVK1 rallies, I would rather see an El Cid Isong. I would rather see a Minamoto Cao Cao, right? Like, there's better choices in my opinion. And you know, again, maybe you'll see him there. But besides that, his skill damage, absolutely atrocious. What is this 400 damage? What is that, dude? What is that? And so you deal 400 damage factor to one target, and then it's a three target fan shaped area for his expertise for a 300 damage factor? What even? Dude, seriously? Now I know he reduces their damage and defense by 25% for 5 seconds. Yes, that's a big debuff, but it only matters if the rest of his skills are actually good or usable or something like that, in which case I would have to argue that they aren't, because guess what, you guys? There are literally no stats on this commander. Where are the stats? Where's the attack? Where's the defense? Where's the health? Why would you make a rally commander that doesn't give you stats? I don't get it. Yes, you're increasing, you have bonus damage, but your damage is so low because you don't have any attack points. Like, what? Again, what are you dealing, normal attack and counterattack damage? Again, just go with Attila Takeda. And I know you can just get Barca just whenever you want. You can get Barca, but that's the problem, is you have to spend $300. Like, seriously? His third skill, only for hitting cities, literally not for flags or forts, only cities. And you're healing yourself when you're hitting a city, okay? I just don't know what they were thinking, man. I don't know what they were thinking. If you're gonna charge people $300 for a commander, it's gotta be somewhat useful, right? Like, come on, this is absolute trash. And look, he gets another 15% damage, but you gotta be outside of your alliance territory, which means you're gonna get swarmed down anyway. Completely embarrassing, totally awful commander. I really would love to see some sort of buff for this guy, because man, this is embarrassing. But guess what, guys? It gets worse than Barca. It gets worse than Barca. And you know what? One of the cool things about KVK1 is that if you fight and you're on the front lines and you are spilling blood and you're staying up till 2-3 in the morning, teleporting, defending territory, losing troops, using speed ups, burning resources, and absolutely waging all out war, you will be rewarded with the worst legendary commander in the game. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I hope it was worth it, because Charlemagne is absolute trash. He is the worst commander you could be investing in the entire game. And let me explain why. His primary skill is one of the worst primary skills I've seen in a long time. He literally deals flat 1400 damage factor. Is that a high damage factor? No. Is it AoE? Also no. Is he buffing you? Nope. Is there debuffs? Also no. I'm like, where's the rest of the skill, bro? Like, what? This is a legendary, right? Okay, where's the rest of the skill? What is this? Like, every epic in the game has a better active skill than this. Seriously, what's going on here? Okay, well, certainly he makes up for it in other places, right? Like, he probably gives you a lot of stats. Also, no. He gives you 20% of stats if you're rallying. That's it. Not in the open field. No other scenarios. So, unless you're rallying, Charlemagne's also not giving you stats. So, terrible active skill, no extra stats. Now he does have a chance of getting a shield, but guess what? The shield's actually worse than some of the other shields in the game. It's worse than Martell's, it's worse than Alex. Those two commanders get a shield guaranteed every time their skill goes off. He gets it once every, you know, 10 seconds or so. Sure, there's no internal cooldown, but you know, who cares if you're shielding when you're not dealing any damage? You look at his last skill, his fourth skill. He's giving you an increase in skill damage. Okay, so his terrible active skill is going to get buffed by a smaller percentage than other legendary commanders. Let's take a look here at our boy Isong, right? Isong, flat 50% of skill damage bonus, constant, all the time. Charlemagne, he has an absolute atrocious skill damage increase, and it only gets better if he loses troops, and even at complete max, it's worse than the constant you get from Isong Ye. Literally every one of his skills is outclassed by some other commander in the game by an absolute massive amount. Everything about this commander is trash. You would need to buff probably every single skill by a significant amount before people even remember that Charlemagne exists. Now I hear what you're saying, but Omniarch, his expertise will save you some deads. And guess what, you guys? Maybe if the rest of his stats were okay, his expertise would be decent. But guess what? You're going to be losing so many more troops because you decided to rally with Charlemagne as opposed to an actual rally commander, that if you see a Charlemagne rally, I want you to screenshot it and send it to me personally, because I have never seen an effective or even an attempt to use Charlemagne as a rally commander because he's that bad. He's absolutely trash. He does nothing well. He does nothing well. I don't even want to hear it in the comments. I don't even want to hear it, dude. If you're typing that comment right now defending Charlemagne, I want you to delete it before you post it. Delete it before you post it, because you're wrong. Now, one thing you should notice here is that all of these commanders are leadership commanders. So worst commanders in the game are leadership. That's pretty embarrassing. I think Lilith perhaps should do something about that. I'm kidding. There's plenty of leadership commanders in the game that are actually decent and are actually things that you can possibly use. But guys, if you enjoyed this video, if you found it useful or informative, or if I helped you save some legendary commander sculptures, I'm gonna need you guys to drop a thumbs up on it. It really does help out the channel a ton. And subscribe to the channel if you're new around here, and click that bell to be notified the next time that I upload a Rise of Kingdoms video. This video is more geared towards newer players, so that means you're probably new around here. About 75% of you guys are not subscribed, so click the button. It's fast, it's free, it's easy, and it helps. Comment down below what you think are the 6 worst legendary commanders in the game. Did I hit this nail right on the head, or do you have something to say? Do you have some words for me? Montezuma's gonna be OP, you wait and see, Omniarch. I hope he is. I hope he is. He's got a cool design. I think he's awesome, but I don't see it. Anyway, as always, my social media links are in the description below, so make sure you follow me over there on Instagram, Twitter, Discord, all that good stuff. It's always down below, so go ahead and do that. And also, there's a link down there to download Rise of Kingdoms absolutely for free for your PC or your Mac. It's a program called BlueStacks. It's my favorite way to play Rise of Kingdoms, and honestly, I think you have an advantage if you're playing it on a much bigger screen and you don't have to use your large fingers to tap on a tiny little phone screen when you're trying to wage a big battle where you could be losing thousands and thousands of troops. So click the link, give it a try. It's, like I said, it's 100% free forever, and if you don't like it, just uninstall it. It's fine. With that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. This has been Omniarch. I will talk to you guys again soon. Peace.